Man, tell us about that whole journey, your journey back in the 80s and with Truth and everything.
At 13 years old. Wow.
So in my household, my nieces, they live in Atlanta.
And he took a swing.
Oh, boy.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening.
Yeah. Aren't you glad we didn't go through?
Great. I'm going to move you over here, and I'm going to put you right in the middle. Is that all right?
Perfect.
Okay.
And the artist that we have this week, it's a young lady by way coming to us by way of Memphis, Tennessee. I've been down to Memphis a couple of times, and her name is Demi Lo. And let's welcome Miss Demi Lo to Les Holmes Stories of Music. Hey, Demi Lo.
How you doing?
You guys?
Good.
We're fantastic. Fantastic. I like the little yellow thing you have over your head right there. What is that?
Oh, it's a really, really old phone. It came with my house. Yeah. It used to work, but it doesn't anymore.
Not anymore.
You know how to use it? Look.
This way, with just one finger. Yeah.
What do you do? You push it or you turn it? How do you
turn it? Right.
She's turning.
Okay. All right. Well, welcome to the show. We're so glad
to
have you.
Thank you so much for having me.
And you know what? I know we got a long way to go with you because I know you're going to have a very, very, very huge blossoming career. So I'm already going to extend to you a return invitation, so you're welcome to come back anytime you like. So we're going to do that now, okay?
Yes.
So you can't say no.
Okay.
Okay. So Demi Lo, tell us about Demi Lo. I know you're from Memphis. I know that you're a dancer. You started out what 17 or maybe sooner than that. Tell us about Demi Lo. Tell the world about Demi Lo.
Well, I'm actually thinking of changing my name to Demi L'Oreal instead of Demi Lo, because Demi Lo actually sounds like kind of a rap name to me. So I was thinking about other R&B artists like Jasmine Sullivan, Beyonce Knowles, all this. So like, I would just think about why not just use your whole middle name. So now I'm going to go by Demi L'Oreal. So Demi L'Oreal has started singing really young, around kindergarten. And I used to sing all over school, all over the house. And I even got in trouble for singing because I wouldn't stop singing.
What kind of songs would you sing?
Alicia Keys. I used to love Girl on Fire. I used to love singing Girl on Fire. And my mom actually called me singing in the bathtub once and uploaded it on Facebook. And that's how everybody knew that I could sing, that I had something. And I had actually gotten in trouble for it in kindergarten because they were like, she just won't stop singing. And my mom had to tell me, you have to stop singing while you're doing your work because that's distracting the other kids. But they definitely inspired me to be in the music, to get into the music industry, because they were just like, since this is what you like to do, why not make your dream come true? And so here I am today.
Yeah.
Well, welcome to the music world.
Thank you so much.
How has it been so far since you've been, like, you've crossed over now? Everybody knows who you are, what you sound like. So how is it now from just singing all over the place to being more, I wouldn't say boxed, but more controlled with your singing? How is that transition going?
It's going great. Before COVID hit, I was in a organization called Heal the Hood, where we were singing around different schools in Memphis. And we were singing to at-risk kids, like people that bullied, people that wanted to be in gangs, people that wanted to do drugs. It was just like an awareness thing that we used to do. So we can just tell kids that there's more to life than just that. You can also showcase your talent by singing, acting, dancing, all of that. Yes.
So tell us about the dancing.
So I used to be in ballet when I was little, but I stopped for a little while. But now that I'm getting into the music industry, I have to get back into it. My cousin, his name is Trail. He's currently teaching me choreography.
Okay.
So when we do a show later on, he'll be able to teach me and I'll be able to dance on stage.
Who is some of your favorite dancers right now? Because I got a few of them myself, but I want to hear what you got to say. Who are you? Who's some of people that inspire you right now as far as dancing?
Michael Jackson, Beyonce, Les Twins.
They're amazing.
Dancing twins, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I watch a lot of dancers on YouTube also.
Who do you follow? Who are you following?
Aaliyah, Janelle. Nicole Kirkland, those people.
Yes. Yeah. So that's what's up.
Yes. That's some of the people I watch.
Okay. So you picked up some stuff from them, or when did you get it started dancing? I know your cousin is, doing your choreography now, but growing up, who did you, mimic dancing? How did you, how'd you get into that part of it?
Beyonce, most definitely, especially with the Single Ladies video.
excuse me, I understand.
Yeah. I always used to copy Beyonce all the time. Mom just put me into ballet first before I could get into hip hop, jazz, tap, all of that. So I started around third, fourth grade.
Okay.
Yes.
So you cold with it right now then, huh?
I'm getting there. I'm a little rusty, but I'm getting there.
That's good.
So tell us about your movie career. Tell us about that.
Well, when I was in about the fourth or fifth grade,
mm-hmm.
there's this studio in Memphis called Lily Rose Studios that and the director of that was actually my friends. It was actually my sister's friends. I'm sorry, and she just used to give us acting lessons, tell us how to project our voice, and tell us how to move on stage, blocking all of that. And I was actually showcased in a little short film that we did, and it showed in a movie theater. So that was pretty cool.
What was the name of the movie?
I forget.
It's okay. Don't worry about it.
It's been a while. It's been a long time. It's been a really long time.
So tell me about working with Winston Stewart of the Barqués.
I love Winston. He is so sweet and so talented. We had actually gotten to the studio and made a little gospel album together.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually did a little distribution deal on that. And he's just a really talented guy. And I was just blessed to work with him.
Okay. All right. So, I'm looking at the Barqués. So what you know about the Barqués?
My dad.
Your dad tell you all about it. Okay.
Yes, my dad is all about the old school music. He has an old school playlist that he listens to it every day. And I listen to it in the car with him.
Yeah. Barqués. They're like the Holy Ghost, and it's a whole, I can go through that whole thing and reminisce on riding around with my brothers, and listening to the Barqués. That's a whole totally different. You don't know nothing about the Barqués.
Oh my God.
You don't know about the Barqués.
No, a little bit.
You know what? You're right there in the city with them, especially Larry. So yeah. So that's all good. That's all good. Yes. So you released your first single in 2019. And what was your first single?
It was called Moving On. And this song came to be, I was so young. I was probably around 15, 14, and mm-hmm. I didn't really know about love back then, but I heard enough love songs to know what love was about. So I just wrote this song, not off of experience, but off of other people's experience. And I just found a beat on YouTube, and I just wrote something down, and I showed my parents, and they were like, this sounds really good. So we just went to a studio and recorded it. And we made a video to it.
Okay. All right. So let me fold my arm. So you say you heard about love. Huh?
Yeah.
That's what you said.
Yes.
Mama, you hear that? I know you're back there listening, Mama.
My dad's back here.
Okay.
I'm
Okay.
That is funny.
He said it's even worse.
Oh boy. So are you dating right now or not yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
Maybe good.
You know what, Dad?
Good. Good. I have five of y'all. Okay. Mm. Five. Number okay. girls. So take yeah. your time.
So you understand why the folding of the hands and
yeah,
like what take your time.
What you know about love? What you talking about?
No, her music is her boyfriend. She's in love with her music and her dancing and her career right now. So she's gonna be very successful. See, I got you, Demi. That's I got good. You.
Yes,
that's good. Demi Lorel.
Yes, Demi Lorel.
So what's next for Miss Demi Lorel right now? Right now, what are you working on right now?
I'm working on shows because I have
which one?
Well, I have a show coming up in South Carolina. Someone from my team named Joe, he set it up for me, and we're just practicing on that. I have the choreography. We have the two cover songs that I'm gonna do, and we're gonna perform "I'm Ready Last." So, okay. Yeah, it's just.
Have you ever been to South Carolina?
No, ma'am, I haven't.
Uh-oh. So what are you expecting there?
I don't really know. I'm just kind of neutral on it right now. I'm not, probably when it gets closer to it, I'll get a little bit more nervous and on.
And the butterflies will come. Yeah.
But I'm excited for the most part.
That's good.
Yeah.
And then after that, where do you guys go? Sorry, Les.
No, I'll go.
Oh, where do you guys go after South Carolina?
There's a concert in Memphis called Dream Fest, and it's over by the zoo. It's called Live It Shell, and I'm gonna do a performance there also. And we haven't really got enough details about that yet, but that's all I know about it.
Okay. So it's like a mini kind of tour type something. Yes, got you.
So let me ask you this. So you haven't been to South Carolina, nothing like that. Have you? I guess you really haven't done any traveling yet. So,
The pandemic, yeah.
Right. Well, that too. So, where, any place? What place would you love to go and perform? Any place, pick it.
I'll say L.A.
L.A.
Yes, because it's so big. I don't know. Probably New York, too.
You will be performing in both places, like anywhere in the world. Where, like, you're going to be there. Like, that's not even a question. You're going to perform in New York. You're going to perform in L.A. But then, like the center where you, like, the, what is it called? Like, the Lincoln Center or the, the park. What is it called, Les?
Central Park.
Said it again?
Not Central Park.
The places where they perform in New York. The stadiums. The ones.
You talking Madison Square Garden?
The garden. Yes. Yeah. You know, I'm thinking park, and it's a garden. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Madison Square Garden. Like places like that, you'll perform there. Are you excited about that? Or like the Today Show, stuff like that?
Yes,
like,
I'm very.
Like
excited.
What's like your dream? Like what is your dream performance gonna be like?
Probably somewhere out of the country, really. Somewhere that, I don't know, it just made me seem like I'm worldwide, like I'm international.
Yes, that's what I'm talking. Yes. That's what, you know, when Les asked that question, that's what I thought you were going to go. I thought you were going to go international, but it's okay though. It's all right. You're going to perform in New York. You're going to perform in LA. So that's a good thing. And then find your spot in internationally where you want to go. And then that'll be cool too.
Let's go out and let's have a good time.
Good time.
I'm yours in your mind. Let's go out and let's have a good time. 'Cause baby, I don't want this night to be over already. 'Cause we're too young to just be too steady. I don't wanna keep to be your late night call. Can't hide these feelings, I tell it all. Hope you're not afraid to show it. Nah, baby, I know you'll take my fall. I'll be the one to show you real love. What I love about you, all the above. And you know that I love when you call me. Yeah, so baby, just call. I'ma shine wherever I'm gonna be. Ride around downtown with the top open. Say the words, I'ma put you back in focus. If you wanna go, you better keep up. This ain't for the way you gotta start up.
Your alarm clock. When I heard your voice, yeah, my heart stopped. Don't look at me, I know you don't believe me. No one never told you my love was easy. No one never told you my love is cheesy. Knowing me, I post it like graffiti. All I ask is you to never just leave me. And I'm here for you and never.
Baby, I don't want this night to be over already.
So let me ask you this now. When you did your video, what was that like?
My first video? Well, for my first video, it was really fun. We had a lot of fun. My cousin actually did the video. Everything kind of runs in the family here. Everybody kind of does okay. their own thing talent-wise.
Okay.
And, okay. Yeah, it was really fun, and I really enjoyed it. And I was just so excited because I was just like, wow, my first video. But yeah, mm-hmm. it was very exciting.
So what about I'm Ready?
I'm Ready was really fun to make. I had a lot of people with me. We all had great ideas of how the video should be. I actually had the idea of having it in a skating rink because I think it's that kind of vibe. And everybody was just like, well, yeah, let's do it. And we went to a skating rink. We got outfits. We had acting, actors, my cousins actually. And
did everybody know how to skate?
Well, I don't know. I don't really know how to skate myself, but I like the idea of skating.
But it had that vibe. We were going to learn today, right?
Yes, ma'am. Of course. Yes, most definitely.
So I have a question. This is, and I don't know, maybe someone's asked you this question before, but you mentioned something earlier about your name sounding like a rapper. So when I found out about you, I was wondering if you were a rapper, and you're not. The question is, why R&B?
Well, I've grew up around a lot of R&B, and that's really influenced my musical style. But I would like to branch out into other genres too, not only R&B. I would like to get into rock, even country. Yes.
Good idea.
Just gospel. Just a whole lot of other genres. I just don't want to be placed in one genre only. I want to branch out and do other things too.
I agree.
You don't want to be boxed in.
Because yes, what she said earlier was she said she got in trouble for singing all over. She sang everything. So it might as well, right? Do you write?
Yes.
I mean, I know you write because you said so earlier, but like, do you write for other people or just you write for yourself only?
I haven't written for anybody else yet. I hope in the future that I will, but.
Oh, yeah.
I write for myself now.
Okay. So everything you've written on your own right now or?
Yes.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
So you like super crazy talented. Now, where you get your beats and stuff from?
I get them from YouTube, but I know that's a bad thing to get my beats from because everybody was.
It works. It's working right now, right? Isn't that working right now? You about to level up, so you're gonna, you know, okay.
Yeah.
So just YouTube now, and where else? Where else you get your beats from?
My producer Ray Nelson. He's
okay. That's what's up?
Yeah. He actually did the beat for I'm Ready.
Okay.
And he's gonna be working on more beats for me in the future.
That's what's up.
So I'm ready. Mm-hmm. I'm ready for what?
The music industry.
Okay, that's better. Yes. Yes, you cleaned that up really well. Yes. She's ready to blow. She's ready to blow up. That's what it is. Yes.
Okay. All right.
Look at the dad. You see the dad in him, right? Like, what you ready for? Like?
Yeah. Yeah. So do you think you'll stay in Memphis or do you think you'll eventually move away from Memphis or you'll just go where you need to go?
I'll say go where I need to go. Sorry. Go where I need to go. Yeah.
Okay.
Because I love Memphis. I love my hometown, but sometimes I want to go, but sometimes I want to get away. So
yeah,
probably later in the future.
Okay. All right. I got you. That makes sense.
Sing. Let us sing our songs. She just going to sing us to sleep, you know, wake us up singing and sing us to church and sing us back home. So just,
So do you ever think that you'll come further down south, like into the Houston Metroplex area?
Oh, yes. Well, yeah, I just left there actually. Last week me and my mom had went to Austin and Houston. And it was
really
very nice. I really enjoyed it. I would definitely go.
You like which one you enjoy, Houston or Austin?
Both.
Okay. Okay. I can't really choose. That was a trick question, right? You know, he was trying to set you up, like answered it correctly. See, you passed the first test. You're a superstar already. You know how to answer questions. So that's
Yeah, I say both.
Okay. See, I love her. See, already.
So where did you go in Austin?
Well, we actually went down there because my aunt, she had to pick up her grandson, but we just went anyway because she wanted somebody to go with her. So my mom was like, let's go with her. And we went and I really enjoyed myself. I really love Texas.
So tell your mom next time you guys go to Austin, if you get an opportunity, go out to Lake Travis.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
And then go out to Oasis. It's beautiful. Okay. They have one of the most beautiful sunsets you'll ever see.
Wow.
Just,
I personally took a picture of that sunset. It is to die for. It's something out of a picture, out of a movie. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I almost definitely tell her. I would tell her.
Yeah. Oasis.
Come to Houston.
Listening to Oasis.
When you come to Houston, you'll be a little older too, so you'll be able to do what you want to do.
Yes, exactly.
Now, see, she's trying to get you in trouble.
No,
I'll just
no
checking.
Trouble at all. None at all. Yeah, I'm here. You see, my halo is being held up by the horns, but that's okay.
So how can people follow you? How can we get in touch with you? How can we see what's going on in Demi Lo's life?
Well,
or what's happening with you?
Oh, okay. My socials and everything, you can see what's happening with me. On my Instagram is Demi_Lo1. My Facebook is Demi Lo, and my Twitter is DemiLo57.
Okay.
And my YouTube is Demi Lo also.
Yes.
Okay.
Just be on the lookout for more things coming. New music, new performances, new blessings.
That's right, girl.
See, you were raised right. I like you.
Properly. Yes.
I like you. So who would you like to perform with if you had a choice? I'm going to give you three. I'm going to give you three.
Okay.
With four fingers up. That's four less. four.
I'll say Beyonce, of course.
Yes. Okay.
Rihanna, and I'll say
yes,
Ariana Grande.
Oh, the heavy. She hit hard. She hit heavy off the rip. Okay.
Yeah.
And what type
so
of
why?
Like, just, oh, go ahead. So go. Sorry.
So why those?
Because they're all powerhouses, and they all do great performances. I love watching their performances on YouTube, and they're just a big inspiration to me. I just love them.
Yeah, they put in a lot of work too. They work very, very hard to be where they are.
Yes, yeah, very, very determined. That's my inspiration from them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So do you think you have what it takes? And I'm not drilling you. I'm just asking. I'm just asking to put in that kind of work. Would you want to put in that kind of work?
Of course. Yes. Anything to get to where I want to be in life. Yes.
Okay.
Right. My passion. I can't see me doing anything else.
I mean, she's on here with us telling us about, you know, what the great thing she's doing. That's a start right here. You know what I mean? But you've already put in a lot of work too. So like, you got to keep it up, though. Like, sometimes you may not be able to sleep. You may not get the right food that you want to eat because it's like, you got to do it.
Yes, ma'am.
I
already heard.
Uh-huh.
Well, so I know you're a church girl.
Yes.
So I'm going to give you this one. This is the daddy thing. So the preacher says, faith without works is dead. So you can believe all you want to and have all the faith you want to hope you get these things. You can have all the faith, but you got to work at it. So sounds like to me, you're willing to work. You're going to put in the work. So that's good. That's good.
Yes.
You got my support. You have our support. So we got you covered.
Thank you so much. Wishing you all the best.
And I'm hoping to see you back here again. And give us your socials again. How can we stay in touch with you?
My YouTube is Demi Lo. My Instagram is Demi_Lo1. That's DEMI_LO1. My Twitter is DemiLo57. And I already see all the three. I already see Facebook. Yes.
That's all right.
Please go subscribe and like my videos.
There you go. Yes. That's what you do right there. Yes. Well, thank you so much, ma'am. It's been such a pleasure. It's been such a joy to have you on the show.
I love your spirit.
Thanks for having me.
You're really a breath of fresh air. You inspire me too.
Thank you so much. That means a lot. Thank you.
Yes.
So don't forget now. You got an invitation in the beginning, so that means you can't say no later.
All right. I know. Thank you so much for that. I most definitely will come back.
Okay. All right. Well, everyone, thank you for joining us for another episode of Less Home Stories of Music. And you've met the young, very talented dancer, singer, Demi Lo. Demi Laurel. Now
yes.
we got the scoop. Demi Laurel, and make sure you follow her on all of her socials. And until next week, we'll talk to you later. Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye. Bye.